What more can you do? What the fuck, Sunohara? I wake up to the distant voice. Mei-chan, keeping her voice low, as if she's having a private conversation. She talked plainly, yet somehow apologetically.
Hi.
After a short while, I finally realized she's talking on the phone. I wonder who she's talking to. Could it be? The new key projects? All I know is they're making a new summer pocket. The game of the year edition. I'm waiting on that to get into like an English translation. That's the only new key project I heard. Unless you're talking about the new anime, The Day I Became God. I don't think that's a key project. I think that's just Jun Maide thing. He's basically key though. Yeah. It looked like she was talking to her parents. When I tried moving to the kitchen, her phone call is about to end. With the receiver still in hand, she lets out a deep sigh. It seems she doesn't have much time left here. During lunch break, I walk through the hallway, alone. Sunohara still hasn't come yet, but it's just about time for him to get to school. I don't want to face him right now. He probably feels the same way. Guess I'll go buy some bread and eat it somewhere else.
Okazaki-san!
It's what I thought of doing when someone calls out to me. It was someone walking a group of three. I remember him being in my class when I was a first year. Hey, been a while, hasn't it? He's still the same. It's that he wears his uniform somewhat casually. However, it's not like these guys are delinquents or anything. They just do absolute minimum amount of studying and pretend they're good little kids in front of the teachers. The point is, they're guys I could hang out with. I still remember how I would get on well with them. So I exchange words with them once in a while.
今日はスノハラと一緒じゃないんだな?
For now.
飯だろ?一緒に行かね?
That happened in a Tomoya route too. For some reason, there's some people that like Okazaki. That's not, you know, the main characters. That happened in Tomoya. They invited him for lunch, but he had to deny because Tomoya was being, She told Okazaki, no, you can't. Well, I don't mind. Maybe this kind of thing would be nice in a while.
What's that? Hey, そいつゲンチャリで近くまで来てよ.
Primer doll? That's pretty interesting. I'll click on it later.
ありえねって。つうかさ、この間の女紹介しろよ。
However, I immediately regret my decision. I can't talk with them about anything, and I feel extremely out of place. I'm even starting to get angry at myself, occasionally forcing a smile and laughing. So I be sometimes. I slip out of there as soon as I can, under the pretense of taking an afternoon nap. I sit down on the bench in the courtyard and do nothing. I'm a bit annoyed. Even he's an idiot, I could at least tease him. Damn it. It's a little shocking that I'm thinking of helping Sunohara. But I do feel I need to do something. For Mei-chan as well. I wonder if there's anything I could do to help. So, just what am I supposed to do? Why'd that guy get like this in the first place? Naturally, part of it is because he's been going crazy ever since he's been with Sanae-san. However, I just try thinking about it from a more fundamental point of view. So I decided to think about it from step one. He entered the school under a sports recommendation. However, he became unable to participate in his usual club activities. You know, technically, Mei route is actually a Sunohara route. For both, Yohei and Mei Sunohara. Just like the Fujibayashi sisters shared a route. I think Sunohara and Mei share routes. So we get to know more about Sunohara this route too. His grades have been rapidly dropped. He stopped going to classes. In the end, he became a habitual latecomer and even gave up on going to university.
Two different projects in the post to write is intriguing. Like Romeo Tanaka and one for another Ryushiki. For the doll project? What's it called? Primal Doll.
And then he started living his day-to-day life, right, doing nothing. It's actually completely the same for me, isn't it? It's something I already knew, but once again, I feel I have my wits in. He truly is a hateful god. So in the end, I was made to realize that he and I really are the same. Though that also means that if I look back at myself, I might figure out a way to understand him. I roused myself and put my brain to work. When did everything become such a hassle for me? I guess it was around the time I stopped going to my club activities. In that case, the same probably true for Sunohara. However, there are one thing that was different between us. I would never again be able to do any proper physical activities. Starting the day my dad ruined my shoulder in our fight. However, he is different. Maybe things would change if he joined a soccer club again. I merely drowned out that thought along with a bitter smile. There's no way he could show his face there after all this time. He himself probably wouldn't agree to it either. Not to mention the soccer club would never accept him back to begin with. However, no matter how much I thought about this, that's the only thing that comes to mind. It seemed Mei-chan agreed with me. Yeah, but it's too late for that now.
I understand.
Yeah. I don't think he's at school anymore right now. Since I heard he was bragging about walking home with Sanae-san. That's what that would mean,
yeah.
But you know, Mei-chan, the problem is who's going to take him in? Have you thought of that?
Wait,
are you serious? Those guys seriously hate Sunohara. They couldn't enter the tournament because he had a fight with a student from another school. Looks like she's firmly determined. So with that small body of hers, with that gentle voice, she's going to go there and try to negotiate. For no other reason than her brother. If that's the case, I can't just let this go by and let her go alone. I'll come too.
Okazaki-san.
I might as well see this through until the end. Let's go, Mei-chan. Damn, hype. First, we visit the coach. Sunohara is quite infamous with the students, so I really didn't want to let Mei-chan go around like this. Never. It's not like I could stop her for something like that. We approach a middle-aged man wearing a jersey, smoking cigarettes in the courtyard. I can smell the stink of nicotine and sweat once we start to get closer. He raises his voice without warning, and I'll bet with a start. Mei-chan raises her voice.
I'm not a employee. I'm Sunohara Yohei's sister, Mei.
Sunohara? Sunohara? Sunohara って 3年 のか?
はい。 その Sunohara です。
He gives a dry laugh for no reason. That gesture annoys me somehow.
Sunohara の実家は 東北 だろうが 俺は 知ってるんだ。
そうですけど。 でも 本当 なんです。
学校は どう したんだ? ちょっとお休みをもらってます。サボりか。兄が兄なら妹も妹だな。それともあれか岡崎。お前がそそのかしたのか。岡崎さんはそんな人じゃありません。あの話を聞いてください。兄のことなんですけど、以前 部に迷惑をかけてしまって。でも、もう十分に反省していまして。できればサッカー部への復帰を認めてほしいと思ってお願いに来ました。復帰？はい、そうです。あの、どうでしょうか。わざわざそれを言いに来たのか。
I heard that this coach had a sharp tongue, and I knew that he had a tendency to quickly brand people as idiots. Even so, he was horribly pissing me off.
本気で言ってるのか、そんなこと。本気に決まってます。だからお願いしに来たんです。スノハラ。ね。
He folds his arms and groans for a while. The smoke from the cigarette spreads, and Mei-chan gives a slight calm.
あ、難しいわな。あいつの不祥事のおかげで、今の3年は新人戦出られなかったんだからな。だけど、その…大体、お前がそれを言ってどうする。本人が言いにこんか。人が…私が連れてきます。絶対に連れてきます。
謝罪もさせます。もう問題なんか起こさないように約束させます。だからお願いします。正式な入部でなくてもいいです。しばらく様子を見てあげてください。バカか。口では何とでも言えるだろうが、あいつが素直に謝るような玉か。そもそも今までサッカー部に寄りつこうともしなかったのに、
そんなことできるわけなかろう。そんなことありません。大体来ても迷惑なだけだ。2年もブランクのあるやつが使い物になるか。ま、玉拾いぐらいだろうな。それならどこか兄がプレーできる場所紹介してくれませんか。おお、いいところがあるぞ。
スポーツ少年団なんかどうだ。岡崎、なんだその目は。
His insensitive words are pissing me off from the bottom of my heart. Before I know it, I find myself glaring at that stubbly mug of his. However, if I say something here, I'll ruin everything. Nothing. I avert my gaze and try to put up with it.
兄ちゃんは確かにずっと怠けていましたけど、 でも、サッカーはうまいです。きっと、どこか活躍できる場があるはずです。
あのぐらいはどこにだっている。
そんなことありません。
あのな、 俺は何人も選手を見てきてんだ。あれは盆栽だな。盆栽ならまだいい。協調性はない。甘くさえ暴力を振る。足にも棒にもかからんよ。
でもやってみせればわかると思います。ほんの少しでもいいんです。お兄ちゃんにもう一度チャンスをあげてもらえませんか。
頭を下げられてもな。第一、部の連中が認めんだろう。篠原と一緒にプレーするなんて嫌がるんじゃないのか。
いや、
わかったか。黙ってちゃわからんだろうが。
いえ、じゃあ部の人が認めたら。
ああ、
部の人が認めたら監督さんも認めてくださいますか。これから部員の方にも話をしてみます。もし皆さんが認めてくれれば。
認めれば、ま、判断材料にはしよう。
本当ですか。
疑ってるのか。
いえ、その失礼します。
メイさん。 She lowers her head. She appeals to me with her eyes and starts walking away. She must be planning on going to the sports ground now. I try to follow after her.
待てよ、岡崎。
What?
その子が挨拶できるのか。お前ができないわけがないわな。
Excuse me. I said about lowering my head and falling after Mei-chan. Mei-chan moves along the corridor silently yet quickly. Her eyes slightly red. She's tightly clenching her fist. It seems she's trying to bear her frustration. Mei-chan. I softly hold onto her small clenched fist.I want to encourage her, even if just a little. Going to the club members, aren't you?
はい。行って話してみます。お兄ちゃんのこと、受け入れてくれるようにって。
She kindly grasps my hand in return. There's nothing I can do here. So at the very least, I want to be beside her. We are at a door with a sign saying soccer club.Mei-chan stands in front of it with a nervous look on her face. Are you okay?
はい。もう平気です。
She takes deep breaths for a short while and nods. As they're trying to encourage herself, she tightly squeezes the handle of the door, then releases it.
行きます。
She puts her hands on the doorknob. The gazes of the half-naked guys in the club room all converges on her. The dusty air flows out of the room toward us.Despite being overwhelmed by the intimidating air here, she mustered her voice.
こちらに部長さんはいらっしゃいますか?
And as she does so, a commotion arises within the club room. Along with teasing voice, the sound of spiked shoes threading a path sounds from within. A man with a large build, hair slightly bleached, step out of the room.
俺だけど、うちの生徒じゃないよな。
私は、その…篠原陽平の妹です。
何?
His eyebrow goes up with a twitch. The same for the other club members.
ですから妹です。メイと言います。
The club room starts getting serious again. Scratching his head, the captain starts talking.
それでその妹さんが何の用だよ。
お願いがあって来ました。兄のことなんですけど。
聞こえねえよ。
兄のことなんですけど。
篠原がどうしたって。
以前こちらの部に入っていましたよね。それでもしよろしければまたお世話になれればと思いまして。
へえ、ちょっと待って。それって再入部したいってこと?
はい、そうです。
本気で言ってる?
本気です。
One of them fails to hold in his laughter.
They're
all whispering to each other, grinning.
それさ、スノハラが言ったの。そういうわけではないんですけど、お兄ちゃんが、あ、いや、兄が。お兄ちゃんだってよ。ブラゴン、お兄ちゃん。Damn.
Cries of ridicule come out of the club room. I launch a glare at them, and they all fall silent.
Okazaki? お前もそう思ってんの?
I'm just her escort. Still, I'd like you to hear this girl out. Please.
お願いします!
Next to me, Mei-chan lowers her head, flustered. All over, there are people laughing, making her out to be a fool. Mei-chan lowers her gaze, both for embarrassment and frustration. Let's go, Mei-chan. I don't think Sunohara is gonna get his act straight anyway, being with these guys. Once again, she faces the club members and deeply bows her head.
お願いします。ちょっとだけ、一日だけでもいいんです。お兄ちゃんにサッカーやらせてあげてください。それがきっかけになると思うんです。お願いします。メイちゃん。お願いします。
Her sorrowful voice echoes throughout the room. However, it seems that too was a wasted effort.
けなげだね。キャプテン、お願い聞いてあげてくださいよ。
どうすっかな?
They each smirk at us.
あり、やっぱダメ。
Seeing Mei-chan dumbfounded like that, they laugh even louder.
ダメだっつーの。キャプテン、ひでー。おいおい、泣いちまうぜ。お願いします。お願いします。Even
as she publicly humiliated in front of so many people, despite even that, Mei-chan just continues raising her voice.
うまくいきませんでしたね。
However, Mei-chan stayed firm. Her eyes are inflamed, and her shoulders are trembling. However, she definitely won't shed a tear. Until the very end, she'll go on with a smile.
だけど、諦めません。絶対に分かってくれると思いますから。You
actually plan on continuing this?
何度でもお願いします。お兄ちゃんを受け入れてくれるまで続けます。 そうすることが一番いいと思います。そうすればきっとお兄ちゃんも。It's
not like she wasn't scared. Being in front of soccer club members, and to those very club members, she frantically appealed like that. And she certainly didn't cry. All she did was lower her head. Just how much courage does this little girl have? Mei-chan's working this hard for you, yet... Sunohara, just what are you doing? Damn, that sucks. I thought Sunohara was saw some of it at least, but damn. It does seem like... It's like wasted effort. Sunohara, I call out to him the moment I get to school.
Okazaki-ka. Nankayo?
He's straining himself to act normally. However, no matter what, he won't make eye contact with me. You and Mei-chan haven't met since then, have you?
Matte-nai-ne.
Aren't you worried about her?
Nande omae ga sonna koto yun da yo? Daitai sa, なんで僕がメイのこと気にしないといけないのさ。サナエさんとのことで忙しいしさ。
Oh my god, bro. Are you seriously saying that?
本気だよ。これからもっと忙しくなるかな。前に言ったよね。告白するって。4月も終わったし、今日こそ決めるつもりだよ。そうなるとますます時間なくなっちゃうな。やべ、体が持つかな。
You.
そういうわけだからさ、もうメイのことなんかどうでもいいっていうかさ。
Why? Why are you still trying to act tough?
強がってなんかいません。
You're not worried.
メイがどうなろうと知ったことじゃないね。
Can you knock this off already?
何怒ってるんだよ。ま、あいつも僕のことなんか気にしてないだろうしさ。
Sunohara! Driven by my anger, I grabbed him by the collar. My chair falls down, and a loud noise resounds in the classroom.
なんだよ、お前! つか、わけわかんないぞ!
What do you think Mei-chan's doing right now?
知らないね、そんなこと。どうせお前と仲良くやってるんだろ。僕には関係のないことだよ。
Try grabbing any of the soccer club guys and ask them and what they think of Mei-chan. Maybe you'll understand just how much she believes in you.
わけわかんねえって言ってるだろ。ええ、話せよ。なんだよ。やんのかよ、岡崎。
I can sense spectators are gradually starting to gather as we glare at each other. The classroom, which had been silent as death up until now, turned hectic in one fell swoop. When the teachers come up to us to intervene, I let go of his hand. From within the thick crowd of people, I start heading toward the door. The student hurriedly make a path for me. Some class president or another comes in, shouting at me to stop. I ignore her and leave the school.I skip my afternoon classes. Instead, I go to the park where Sunohara Sanai-san had arranged to meet for the previous date. It's so I can see Sanai-san. When I look around, I notice Sanai-san sitting on the bench ahead of me. Sanai-san! I called out to her as I walk toward her.
Ara, Okazaki-san!
She turns around, giving me a sweet smile. You got a minute?
Gomen-nasai.ちょっと待ってもらえますか?
She looks at me slightly apologetically. I can't say that word for some reason. I hadn't noticed earlier, but Sanai-san is surrounded by several elementary school students. It looks like she's telling them something.
というわけで、女の子はいじめられても嬉しくはありません。でも、優しくされるときっと喜ぶはずですよ。
The boys are all listening to her intently.
もちろん、いきなりそうするのは難しいと思います。最初はほんの少しでいいですから、その子のことを考えてあげてください。まずは、謝ることから始めてみましょうか。
They all nod in unison to her words.
わかりましたね。
They all reply in a loud shout, and then they all run off.Their rucksacks shaking on their backs as they give her their farewells.
さて、ごめんなさい、岡崎さん。
Not at all. Who were those kids just now?
覚えていませんか?
No. Are you saying we met somewhere?
ほら、前に陽平くんとめいちゃんとお出かけした時です。女の子がいじめられていましたよね。
Oh, I remember that.
あの子たちはその時いじめていた男の子です。
は?、huh? Wait, but why were you talking to them?
そうした方がいいと思ったからです。そうしないと根本的な解決にはならないですよね。
So just now you were...
ちょっとお説教です。でもみんないい子でしたよ。話せばちゃんと分かってくれる子です。
So that's what you were doing. As always, this woman. She makes me admire her, and she amazes me.
それで、今日はどうしましたか?珍しいですね。
こんな時間に。あれ？でも今は5時間目ぐらいのはずです。授業はどうされたんですか？
Oh, I skipped.
それはいけないことですね。勉強はちゃんとしないと。
Sunai-san, I talk over her, changing the conversation. There's something important I'd like to talk to you about. It's about Sunohara and Mei-chan. Please, listen.
Hi.
She must have sensed how serious I am about this. She nods, her expression serious. I tell Sunai-san everything. About the reason Mei-chan came to the town. About the state her brother was in when she came here. Or the time gap between now and when he was a reliable person. And finally about what Mei-chan has been doing recently, along with her wish. I tell her everything, omitting no details.
なるほど。わかりました。
I have something I'd like to ask you, Sunai-san.
何でしょうか?
You've been having a date with Sunohara today, right?
そう約束しました。
Well, should it be that he looks troubled about something during that time? Was he worried about something? Then please try reminding him of Mei-chan. Because if you don't, then Mei-chan will...
はい。そうですね。そうなってはいけませんね。
Yes, so...
でも、Okazaki さん、それは心配ないと思いますよ。
は?
ここ最近、なんとなく気づいていました。陽平くんはいつも何か不安げにしているみたいでした。本当は分かっているはずです。きっと、今しなくちゃいけないことするはずです。やればできる子ですよ。
Sunai san. I see. Just now, I finally realized why she's been helping us so much. I think back on the children that all obediently listened to Sunai san earlier. We're probably just like them. The day we met, when she saw Sunohara indiscreetly spitting out insults, she must have thought she had to do something. That must be why she's helping us so much. That's why she agreed to the.The weird plan.
私はそう信じています。必ず気づいてくれると思います。私ができることがあるとすれば、少しだけ背中を押してあげることだけですよ。
I'm so glad it turned out like this. I'm not gonna lie. I thought it would turn out with Sunai's husband beating Sunohara's ass. But it got serious. I was like, hold up, wait a minute. And then.It turned out like this. I'm so glad it turned out like this. This is way better than I imagined. That was... This is like five steps ahead when I could ever think of. So nice one's pretty good. This game is pretty good. All the side characters have their own moments. Even, Ryoko's boyfriend. The nameless NPC who I thought was a nameless NPC. Even he had his own route. And his route was hella sad.Everybody have a purpose in this game. He even called them side characters. I don't know what to call them anymore.
だから、Okazaki さんももう少しだけあの子のことを信じてもらえませんか?
Okay. Right now, all I can do is agree.